Okay, I'll just take it from where Jude stopped. I think the point you were trying to make there with letting them know, look, if you do this, this is the impact it will have on daddy or impact it will have on mommy, is quite key. And it's not exactly even blackmailing them, it's the truth. But it's letting them, facing them with the truth that, look, whatever you do, like I say to mine and I say to all other teenagers and youths that I get to work with, that look, you are ambassadors, and whatever you do will impact other people. You're ambassadors, one for yourself, for your family, and for every other organization that you're connected to, be it your school, be it your church, mosques, or whatever else you're linked to, it will impact on it. And nobody likes to associate with failure. Failure is an orphan. Success has many generations. If you do well, look, there's a lot of us that are ready to stand behind you, you know, and hail you on. But if you don't do well, there's nobody that's going to want to stand with you. The only people that don't have much of a choice are your parents and your family. But even at that, it's not going to go down well with them, and it will have its impact and its effects on them, on their health, and it's making them understand it. But what I was picking up as we were having this conversation is that there's actually two different issues here. There is the issue of parenting a teenager. Whether you're in America, in Africa, in Asia, wherever, that issue is there. Whether you're black skin color or brown skin or white, whatever color you want to call it, that issue is there in every home. There's a phrase that I hate so much, and it's so popular, especially with the internet sensation, African parents be like. I say, well, African kids to be like. And I say to my kids, the truth is, there is no such thing as African parents. The only thing is our style and approaches are different. An Irish parent or an Irish mom is an Irish mom. Mothers are mothers. It's just sometimes our style of doing it may slightly differ. But an Irish mom who wants to instill discipline into her child is going to put her foot down the same way I, as an African mom, will put my foot down. And that's the second thing there, is that there is the issue of the gangs and the issue of parenting teenagers. It's everywhere. I grew up in Africa. We had cults in school. That's what is happening here as well. I mean, that's the same Africa that we're talking about. It's a function of parenting gone wrong. It's happening everywhere. There's no perfect system. One of the things that we probably got wrong is when we got here, we didn't avail of the opportunity that was presented to us, which is that we have the culture coming from wherever we've come from, and then we were presented with a whole new culture. And one thing that we should have done was pick the best of both worlds. The African system doesn't have a perfect system. The Irish system or any other system doesn't have a perfect system. Every system has its own good side and the bad side. But what we didn't do was, how do I fit myself and my parenting system into the new system that I've found myself? And some of us have been able to work around it somehow. But unfortunately, some people haven't been able to work around it. Now we're starting to see the results of that mess that has been created.